lift. Seth, come on. Seth, give me a lift.
Hey, Seth, you were great. Over here. What we got.
You'll be happy to know that I'm keeping up our tradition of Friday movie night, although without you here, the living room is a mess. I really need to pick up all this popcorn and pizza. Whatever that is. The old monster and...
That's the way, Seth. You did it!
I wondered, why do we think that our creations will inevitably turn against us? Kind of crazy. But those movies had a big influence on my research. I thought... What would it take to make artificial intelligence?
Sounds good. Mac, Seth, let's go. place looks wrecked. An empty cell box socket. Little guy must be around here somewhere. Kai, I'm in some kind of crush pit.
You're on the right track. Just have to get past the grinder.
Begin. There you are. Come with me. Charge. on now. Come with me to your socket.
Certain materials are essential to the core production process. While rare on Earth, the crystalline structures we needed were in plentiful supply on Far Eden.
June 8th, 2053. The first transmissions came through, and the news from Earth. It's too terrible for words. During our voyage to Far Eden, Dust Devil broke containment, raced across the globe. The Mandate was able to launch the last of the evacuation ships, but everyone left behind. Billions of lives. Gone.
Look out! Those Corbites are in attack mode!
Tell them that everyone they ever loved is dead. That they're the only ones left. Not now. There are only a few more days in my shift. I'll sleep. Until the next time I wake. After all, what difference will 30 years make? Earth will still be a tomb.
See what this console does. Let's go, Seth. Fire.
Must be the forge. Mac and Seth should be fine. Their friends have really high melting points. But you...
Got it. Don't touch the fire. On your toes. Here we go. Give it to him! down the analyzer. Big ring in a big room?
That's it. Just put the prismatic core into the main console, and we'll be all set.
Cores are missing.
There ought to be an incubation chamber nearby. You should find plenty of cores in there.
Good. A yellow ammunition upgrade. Nice.
Thank you.
one more.
See what makes you tick.
Jewel, if anyone could set things right,
Dad,
I knew it would be you.
Dad!
Kai, did you hear that? There were voices. Coming through the core. Maybe it's some kind of transmission from the ships in orbit.
All I see on my end is a wall of mandate encryption. I don't have enough compute power in my crawler to crack it. But I know a place that does.
The core. It overloaded the analyzer.
The whole foundry.
Okay, I see some energy cells. They look like they're overheating.
Destroy them! Quick!
Hi, I did it. But the analyzer's still going crazy.
There have to be more cells on the other side of the room.
It's okay, Seth. We can do this. We can crack the mandate encryption on the prismatic core?
Far Eden Tower. It was built to control the terraforming process, so it's got to have plenty of compute power. There's a tram at the back of the foundry that leads straight to the E-Tower. I'll meet you there.
All right, sounds good. Seth, let's go.
At peak capacity, the foundry could produce hundreds of cores every month. From there, the cores would be boxed up and shipped all over Far East.
This must be the place. Yeah, Seth. That's quite a view. The tram must be at the E-Tower. This console should call it back. All right. Now we wait. Uh-oh. I guess someone doesn't want us going to the tower.
Almost there! I'm fine, Seth. Just wanted to see what the parts you got me could do. The E-Tower. The heart of Far Eden.
Looks shut down. Just like the pylon in the factory. But not for long.
Listen, Jewel. I didn't want to tell you over the radio. But the voices we heard didn't come from the ships in orbit.
What do you mean?
This might sound crazy. but I think the voices were coming from inside the core.
So you're Victor.
Jewel, get out of here.
What?
Seth can take you and Mac back across the rail.
I'm not leaving you here with him.
Seth is not strong enough to take us all. You've got to keep the core safe no matter what. There's no time to argue, Jewel. Go.
Bring me that door!
Jewel, can you hear me? There's another way to the E-Tower. You'll have to go through a mandate exclusion zone. It's off limits, but you can use my crawler to override the security gate. Be careful, Jewel. Victor's...
Another way into the E-Tower. Don't worry. Kai can take care of himself. He's okay. I know it. He has to be.
Come on, guys. Let's head to the E-Tower.
Come out.
We knew we couldn't tame the entire atmosphere, not at first. Certain areas would have to wait. And in these zones beyond the pylons, the storms would go on.
December 2083. It was good to rest, but even better to wake and see all the progress the core bots have made. The foundry is up and running, thanks to Victor, and exceeding core production targets. The pylons are ready for activation. And I've received news from the evacuation ships.
This must be the security gate Kai told us about. But there's no way we can move those rocks. Let's see if we can find a different way through.
Firmware updates for the core bots. I'm not sure what they've created that they think will improve on my original design, but no matter. It's time for me to wake the other crews. I'm ready to tell them about Earth. Because now, for the first time, I truly believe Far Eden can succeed.
I thought this zone was off limits. Hello? Is anyone here? Look at this. Victor.
He did something to the Korbots. And then he ordered them to attack the crawlers? Why would he do that? They cracked the tube. And then he never woke up. Both of you, wait! You drew that, didn't you? This is your crawler. Your companion inside the tube. Victor attacked the crawl. But you couldn't stop him on your own. Victor hurt my friend, too. His name is Kai. What's your name? Duncan. I'm Jewel. This is Mac and Seth. No, they're not with Victor. They're with me. We're going to the E-Tower to stop Victor and save Far Eden. Will you help us? Good. And I know the first thing you can do.